Hey everybody, welcome back to Northernlion Plays the Binding of Isaac. Afterbirth, we're gonna do another Eden run today. Did we have like D4 shenanigans in our last episode? No, so we don't have the D100. Whoa, our stats seem amazing though. We rolled like a... I think you can only have one or two in stats that aren't augmented by items. So we pretty much rolled, or flipped our coin to heads on 5 out of 6 things here. The only one we missed was luck, which is probably like the least useful stat to have at the start of the game. Maybe that or like shot speed, but either way, tears and damage are good. 89YT XFTG. We started with 3 HP, which is also great. Trinity Shield and Box of Friends. Like, our DPS is so good. This is awesome. I will say that Trinity Shield is good. Box of Friends is presently worthless, but that could change pretty considerably in the future, depending on how things work out for us here. But for now, this is a really, really amazing Eden start, and I appreciate that it's not just traditionally really good. It kind of has a little uniqueness, too, because Trinity Shield is one of those items that very, very rarely shows up. Might as well fight our boss first. Is this... No, it's not an XL floor, so let's try the pill. It's addicted. This is a bad room to have addicted on. Rarely do I actually end up getting fucked by addicted. But if we get hit once here, that'll cost us one full heart. But, I mean, we do have 3 HP, so on the first floor, that's not a real problem. But you can see, like, if I had done this and we'd had an Eden run where we only had 1 HP, that would be a real issue. In case you don't even know what addicted does, it just gives you double damage. Or you take double damage for the room that you use it on, so... it actually can be considerably problematic here, but Speedball is a pretty good pickup. I say it can be considerably problematic, but most of the time you end up popping it after you finish a room and you're just like, okay, well, I'll just walk into the next one then. But I was hoping for, like, Lemon Mishap, because Larry Jr. eats shit on that so easily that, it would have been nice. But Joker, no, 2 of Hearts. 2 of Hearts is actually pretty good for us if we can get to 5 cents and maybe spawn an arcade on the next floor, but... That's looking relatively unlikely here. Ooh, a black heart. Okay. That solves our spirit heart-related woes. We do have a bomb so we can get to the secret room as well. And honestly, we're setting... I'm going to get that, by the way. We're setting a pretty good precedent here early on. I would hate to see, like, Eve's Mascara in this item room. But apart from that, I'm feeling good. Yeah, small rock makes that even better. And I have to admit that I really feel more incentivized to shoot all this poop, not only because I need 5 cents, but because our fire rate is so good that it doesn't take 20 minutes to get it done. We're going to get to 4 cents. Ah, we're going to get to 5 cents thanks to Justice. That's actually really amazing. This is a big surprise. And, you know what, let's just walk over this. I don't want to waste a bomb. And I'll just use two... Nah, we don't need to use it yet. That's a little overly ambitious. But, we got a familiar, and that familiar actually does make Box of Friends usable. I didn't want to say useful, because, you know, two little Stevens is not really that amazing. Holy Christ! We actually got, Fat Odd Mushroom as well. Now, I'm not going to go to the shop, buy a bomb, and then blow up that dude for a chance at a bomb, but Fat Odd Mushroom is an excellent pickup for us. Now we just hope that we can actually get this arcade on the next floor and get enough money to make this happen, but good God... This is, to make the shop happen, I should say, on the next floor. But that is a really, really good first floor. And there is an arcade. So I would say that pretty much absolutely everything is coming up Millhouse right now. Extra HP, extra damage. We just screwed ourselves out of getting into the boss trap room, but at the same time picked up an HP plus speed upgrade in the form of the blood bag. This is ridiculous. Like, we're out of control good right now. No bombs, unfortunately. Never mind, we do have a bomb now, but Minecrafter is a pretty bad item. I think. I really thought that that would maybe get us a chance at the secret room, but whatever. It's possible I missed, but it's also possible that the secret room just wasn't in that area to begin with. This is... incredible. And it's... I mean, Mr. Boom could actually be okay here, but it's incredible in kind of a way that is unique. Yeah, I'm sorry, Box of Friends. You're more interesting, but not as useful right now. It's incredible in the way that, like, basically our stats have just been out of control. We didn't pick up any item that just, like, makes it incredibly easy for us to to win. But we picked up an array of items that make it really, really easy for us to stomp early on here. This is kind of almost, I wouldn't say a foregone conclusion that we're going to win, but like a really, really beautiful setup. I mean, look at the items we picked up since we started. Speedball's fine. Everything else is good. And then we just got the Goathead out of that golden chest. Mr. Boom might not be the most impressive item in the world, but it does probably beat getting a second little Steven every four rooms, although I will admit there's a chance that box of friends could be much better for us in the future, but I find it funny that the only stat that wasn't rolled that amazingly to start with was luck, and yet our kind of luck outside of the game has been, well, outside of the actual, you know, attribute that's included in the game has been disgustingly good so far. Now we've got unlimited deals with the devil. We also have taken no damage on this run so far, partly thanks to Trinity Shield, which allows me to be a little bit more aggressive while also maintaining some safety. I think we take both of these. Empty Vessel's pretty good. Contract from Below, really nice for consumable buffs, and we have so much HP, it's not a big deal. Three of the same pill. It's Relax. That was like the first semi-bad luck. And then Power Pill. We can't get to our boss trap room. We could get to our shop, but we're not going to be able to afford anything. Yeah, I think we just go down to the next floor. There's a chance the shop would be worthwhile, I will admit. And maybe we could have relaxed and shot the poop outside of the boss room for a better chance at money. But it's getting a little too min-maxy for my taste, starting to feel uncomfortable with it. So instead, I am going to move on to the next floor, which is where I already am, as you may have noticed. Yeah, that was bad, but it does... Oh, I was going to say it makes it possible for me to get into that room for free. But honestly, I think we can do that anyway, just via the secret room, which was there. That's just a very common secret room location. Now, if I can push this up here. Man, if this is like Cricket's Head, I'm out. It was not Cricket's Head. By out, I would have meant this is amazing. It just keeps getting better, but I can't keep up this kind of like breathless enthusiasm. I try to treat myself or consider myself as like an optimistic cynic, which is like, hey, you know, life's pretty good, but we are all gonna die someday. I don't wanna be like a Debbie Downer or anything like that, but I try to temper the good with the bad and the bad with the good. You know, I can see the worst in a good situation, but also the best in a bad situation. I think it keeps you flexible. So a run like this where everything is just going amazingly, it's very foreign to me. If you got nothing to complain about, then you know, is that really living? I don't know. Without feeling mildly uncomfortable, it's like I don't know how to react. Okay, Chad is basically screwed. Here's something to complain about. Oh, we don't really need a little bit of HP every single room, but watch us pick up, or every other room. Watch us pick a Dark Bomb right after this and make it incredibly useful. Okay, that's not Dark Bomb, but it is a Guppy item. Truth be told, this is honestly one of my favorite kinds of runs. Runs where you don't ball out of control by picking up like one incredibly powerful item and instead just get like stupid powerful through like an array of stat upgrades, because it kind of feels like it's back to vanilla style. Not that I like vanilla more than Rebirth. I think Rebirth is a much better game than vanilla Binding of Isaac, even though I played vanilla Binding of Isaac for like 3 goddamn years and it has a soft spot in my heart. It's got to be one of my favorite games of all time, which makes it even more impressive that I think Rebirth is so much better, but it's a nice trip down memory lane, I guess is what I'm getting at here, coming out of Queensbridge. Also, when I said vanilla style, you know I was trying to say Big Willy style at some point there, but couldn't quite find the opportunity to sneak it out there. Should maybe look for a second secret room with Mr. Boom, or at least like attack with Mr. Boom. There's no real reason not to. And contract from Below coming through. That's a lot of good consumable drops. I think I'm gonna go for the reroll. I thought about it because Bob's Curse is actually, it would be nice with Mr. Boom, but yeah, I much prefer an item like Sad Onion, really amping up our rate of fire. And Sackboy, which I have to imagine with contract from Below, is just gonna make this disgusting. At this point, if you're pissed off about Northernlion luck in this run, I gotta be honest, you should probably just leave. We're picking up like 5 items, 6 items per floor, and they're largely pretty good. I mean, we got 2 guppy items on this floor, and we have Goathead. We got good damage, and we just picked up Sad Onion. We got Contract from Below, and we just picked up Sackboy. I'm sure you can probably tell for yourself where this run is going, and it's not into any kind of like damage purgatory. You may want to hold out if you still hate me and want to see me suffer, which is a large part of my business, I guess, to be honest, so I can't really begrudge it. But if you still want to, you know, here's our luck. I'm going to get Magic Mush right here. I wasn't all wrong. You got to admit, I wasn't all wrong there. I can't believe that sort of worked out for us. Wouldn't it be great if this room had Magic Mush now, but... you should still hold out if you'd like to see me suffer because of the fact that we could always come across a reroll room and just completely ruin our lives. But the odds of it are not that great. And with the luck that we've been having so far, maybe we'd find a reroll room and just, you know, get disgustingly overpowered. Not that we're not pretty overpowered already. I really can't believe we got a health upgrade when I called Magic Mush. But hey, coincidences do happen. Let's come in here. Pop the world card, see where we're going. There is a dice room! So you're saying there's a chance. Okay, good. We're gonna catch him in the Mr. Boom action here. I do think Sad Onion was a much, much better pickup, but I gotta admit, for a couple of seconds there, I was like, Bob's Curse has got it going on, man. Bob's Curse, Mr. Boom, that's not useless. Not to mention, just 5 extra consumable bombs is not anything to necessarily sneeze at. I'm actually, like, pushing the arrow key as hard as I can to try to shoot even faster than we are. That's... my level of enthusiasm right now is unbridled. Because I am an animal used for farming. What is a bridle? Because if you're unbridled, you're going ham, right? Maybe it's a bridle, that's something used in the world of equestrian, perhaps? It makes your horse... obedient? I have no idea. I grew up in farm country, but have basically no knowledge of it whatsoever. I was the dude, you know, my neighbors would be like, well, you know, we got our livestock auction this weekend, and I'd be like, cool, I'm gonna play All-Star Baseball 98 and, you know, do my grammar homework. I missed out, man. Those are actual, like, life skills that are employable. Having good grammar just, you know, makes you sound like a fucking snob. So I think we're just rerolling all of this. I shouldn't have rerolled the golden key, but it ended up not biting us in the ass anyway. A 3-room is just, you know, it's okay. Umbilical cord, speaking of which, is just okay. The moon gives us a free trip to Boss Rush, if we can get there in time. And, picked up a lot of consumables there. Probably rerolled some other consumables back here as well. We do have to explore everything. Get to our item room. I'm just going to blow this guy up. Not because I want a better deal with the Devil Chance, because we do have the Goat Head. But rather because I don't care to spend 10 minutes playing Judgment for a chance at like the Compass. Which is kind of snobby. The Compass is a great item. I should be more appreciative. Alrighty. Keep it going here. Another double key room, which is irrelevant because of the fact that we have a golden key, thanks to the earlier double key room. I think there's basically no value for us right now in Lazy Worm, but there are situations, like Tech X type situations, where it's actually pretty useful. I was gonna say, there's Magic Mush, but no. We're striking out on that one. Telepills has taken us to the shop, where we will buy Deep Pockets and then leave. Didn't know it was Telepills in advance. It's okay, though. Let's just go do our boss fight. We're gonna backtrack to go to that item room anyway and get our shit back and pick up the moon card again, but we might as well go to the boss fight because we're here and have a good chance to pick up this deal with the devil item. Even if it is a Krampus fight, so be it. Mr. Boom is just working out fantastically right now. Mom's Pearls? I mean, extra luck is fine. The range is semi-irrelevant, but I'll take the extra luck at this point. Bad damage, but do we care about Sister Maggie? You know what, Sister Maggie? Join the party. Even though I took so much damage from doing that, we do have 9 lives, so I'm not sweating that very much at all, if I'm being 100% honest. And now we have Empty Vessel working, which I had totally forgotten about. So even when I try to make a play that is bad why did we get money when we got hit there? Deep pockets, I guess. Maybe? How have I never noticed that Deep Pockets, or at least not remembered that Deep Pockets does that, if it does that? Ridiculous. Okay, Head of the Keeper is awesome. Fate's Reward is not necessarily a bad item. And the more familiars we get, the better. Although I'm starting to feel like I probably should have stuck with a Box of Friends here. But hey, that's what the seed in the video description is for, if you want to play through it on your own time. Okay, we got Addicted and the Moon card. Still a dick, still addicted to you. You guys know the Simple Plan? That wasn't just a Canadian thing, right? I know it wasn't a Canadian thing, because that, like, how could this happen to me? That was like a full-on internet meme. And the internet is not only exclusively restricted to Canada, I think. Last time I checked. Don't really want the addicted pill. And by the way, I wasn't being cocky when I said even when I try to make a mistake or a bad play deliberately, it works out well for us. That it's not because of my skill that it's working out well. It's because we're rolling, you know, quadruple sixes here. It's a one in like, you know, 1,300 chance or something. Just over 1,000 actually. Okay, I think. I was a little concerned we wouldn't be able to make boss rush, because then this whole run would be pointless. But now that we have an XL floor, we probably have a really good chance at it. The bummer, if there is a bummer to have in this situation, see, I'm always finding the silver lining of a dark cloud and the dark cloud of a silver lining. The bummer is that I think I'll just bum rush the boss fight here and then we'll figure it out from there. But the bummer is that we have one less deal with the devil now, so a slightly lower chance to, you know, get the guppy payout, if we were going to get the guppy payout to begin with. Really thought we can get them both, and we did get them both, but it was so close that I actually started into my I really thought we could get them both dialogue when we hadn't gotten them yet. Now that we have Empty Vessel actually working out really well for us, Joker, 2 of Diamonds, also pretty good. I would love to get Sack Dagger, or really like Cube of Mead, or any kind of familiar that is also an orbital. Or actually an orbital. Because this run is great, but it could be slightly greater on a different axis. Is what I mean to say there. What do you think about deck of cards here? I kind of feel like we stick with Mr. Boom. But at least we've replaced a shitty card with a card that is not shitty. Like, I'm enjoying Mr. Boom when I use it, which is probably less frequently than I should, but... Battery charges? I was just gonna say, like, this is... At this point, we pretty much have unlimited batteries. And you know what? With unlimited batteries, I have to come back here and take this. The fact that we can conceivably use it way more often probably makes it heavily incentivized for us to have... for us to have this instead. For us to have cards. So I think here's what we do. I think we use High Priestess on our first boss, come back, get a Stars card, beat Mom, go to the deal with the devil. We might have some shenanigans to pull in that deal with the devil because of our existing HP being weird and also having 9 lives. So if you get like a Judas of Shadow or something, you know how it goes. I really keep thinking we have Sack Dagger as well. Oh my god, we totally missed! I'd like to save the Sun card, but we totally missed with High Priestess, even though from the eye test it looked like we hit. That's okay. I'll get over it in time. That's a second syringe, and of course speed plus damage is also just good to begin with. I'm probably gonna donate there, but I need some time. Where's our Stars card? Here we go. Let's try not to die against Mom. Honestly, it could happen. Like, we could die against Mom pretty easily here. Sackboy Head of the Keeper is just working out disgustingly well. We died, didn't we? Yeah. I mean, it's not a major problem. I'm not gonna act like this is a huge foible for us or anything like that. What's this? Joker. So we're going to the deal with the devil on every floor anyway. But we might as well save this to get into our cathedral deal with the devil, although it's quite a distance. You know what? We have two Joker cards. I'm going to do this. God damn it. It would be really funny if we died so many times we actually couldn't get the boss rush despite getting there so early. Oh, that was a little dicey. Okay. Lump of Coal is great, though. Ah, there we go. Okay, let's pop Strength. And then we actually have a use for the Sun card, although there's HP down here anyway. Oh my god, where's our Stars card? We just got a question mark card, but we have no Stars card. I left it outside, I think. Unless it's one of these? Hold up. Oh my god, I died! Oh shit, we have like no way out now. Joker, question mark card. Okay, pop the question mark card. That gave us the Hermit. We can always Hermit out now. And when we Hermit out, we can go to the shop and buy a Spirit Heart. This is getting a little funny. We also still have the Stars card in here, so I was mistaken earlier. There you go. Keep your HP high. Her only answer was to become a dancer. She kept her HP high. There we go. We're starting to ball here. That was funny for a minute there, though. I was getting a little frightened. I mean, that's what's going to happen when Mom can one-shot you, I guess. Take the Polaroid. Crack this. Judgment. Demon Judgment. That's an interesting one. We'll talk about that. I think we'll take the Parasite. I think most people would agree... That sucks. But most people would agree the Parasite is more entertaining than Ludo. And we're firing so quickly, and our tiers have incentives to be fired, if that makes sense. Like, we generate pennies off of them, and those pennies could also be sacks. So, I do think that this is the right call, but I gotta admit, two pretty good items in there. Got our Hermit. Have we been to the... Oh, you know what? I know exactly how we're gonna do this. We're gonna use our Hermit card to save ourselves a whole lot of backtracking. I'm a dumb idiot, but that's okay. Now, there's all sorts of stuff that we could waste our time with here. Like, there's just a staggering amount of time that I could spend cracking into stuff here. But I don't really care to do so. There we go. Emperor... why use the sun? But Emperor Hermit is kind of our ideal choice here. I honestly don't really care about getting every single sack at this point, because it's actually just gonna... We could play forever, is what I mean to say. And I don't really desire that out of an Afterbirth run, to just play it for 45 hours, you know? But another health upgrade is beautiful. But we'll see how it goes. There may come a time where I need it. Like, trading a bomb for a sack is a good decision, unless we're generating infinite sacks, in which case, what's the point, right? Like, I'm still opening golden chests, because they could pay out with interesting stuff, and... You know, weirdly enough, I'm picking up cards, which makes no sense, because each one of these sacks probably contains a battery. But this is just the totally fucked up economy that we live in this day and age, thanks to the Obama administration. Am I right, or am I right? I'm obviously, I hope it's obvious, being sarcastic here. I don't know anything about politics. And if I did, I wouldn't tell you, because my place as an entertainer is not necessarily to worry about that. Or at least make you worry about that. Okay, this is a little weird, but I think we come in here. I don't think we teleport out, honestly. Come in here, grab this. Take it to a diamonds. We don't need it. What is this? One makes you larger. I'm not mad. Hermit, Emperor. Okay, yeah. We then come in here. Open this. Become Guppy. That's not Guppy. It's Pandora's box, which is actually very good for us, because it gives me an excuse to not look at batteries anymore. Let's look at our other card. Hermit. Actually, like, completely broke even on that exchange then. We're going to wedge ourselves behind this donation machine and donate as much as we can. I really do not want to take Little Baggy. I think Little Baggy, it's weird from a design space. It's not, it doesn't need to be changed, I guess, because Little Baggy is like, it works well with PhD. But at the same time, I kind of wish it gave you, like, the PhD effect when you picked it up. But that would nullify, like, the reasons you would ever be excited to take PhD. So I understand it not being necessarily that beloved. Or that decision not necessarily being so beloved. So we're trying to get this guy to pay out with a flippin' syringe. Gimpy worked out well for us there. I mean, I'll take, like, Sin Robes if you want to give me Sin Robes. Like, that's why we're going hard on this, is because he's got such a good chance to pay out with stuff that is really nice for us. And if we die, we've got 9 lives, so I kind of think it's kind of a decent risk to take. 2 of clubs. I mean, we got, like, 30 bombs there. Really just want some HP, though. He gave us Caffeine Pill. Caffeine Pill gives us a speed upgrade and a health down, which is actually fine, honestly. We got the Hermit. We got a Joker. Do we take Joker Emperor? Yeah, I mean, it's more fun this way to take Joker and Emperor. But we could have taken the health down and gotten a health upgrade out of it instead. But so what I'm thinking is you pop Emperor. Go fight your boss. This gives us a cube of meat, which is really nice if we can then get into Empty Vessel Zone. Or some permanent Polaroid invincibility, at least. We'll take this HP. See how this looks. Okay, we do want Ball of Bandages for sure. We get Rotten Baby, which is great. Oh, we also got the Conjoined transformation there. So we definitely should have kept Box of Friends. Then we head down to the next floor. And I'm really thinking that since we're going to the cathedral, let's go all out and save our Joker card and our Pandora's Box for the cathedral. Like, I want to get Guardian Spear and make this run just as wacky as possible. I also love to become Guppy. Quite selfishly, I would still love that option. I don't know if we've seen Guppy's head, so you know what? I'll take a chance on it. And it was all worth it for the lover's card, baby. He said sarcastically, hoping nobody would notice. Actually, a strength card is pretty useful. We may need that. I'm still hoping to get to Empty Vessel Zone, but hasn't quite manifested itself properly yet. Are we going to fight Hush? That was great use of the Sun card on this floor. But I'm actually happier with the Strength card than the Sun card, honestly. Are we going to fight Hush? We could. I'll leave it at that for now. Because I don't think it's the right decision for us right now. But if we picked up a number of Spirit Hearts, I wouldn't mind it. I mean, our damage is pretty okay. Better at room clearing than at just straight up killing enemies. Like single enemies, but... It's not bad. We did just get another Spirit Heart there. I mean, it's better at clearing rooms because we have Conjoined. So we're just, laying the smackdown on individual rooms here. But individual enemies that are tanky are probably going to be a little bit more annoying. Unless we can get them all in the spectrum of our damage here. And this is the first time I can really recall having Conjoined and feeling like... pretty positive about it, because I think Conjoined is like it's a net positive no matter what, but most of the time it ends up being fairly meaningless. But I mean, it's kind of like having permanent triple shot, right? But without affecting your rate of fire, and also the shot spreading much wider. But that's not necessarily bad. There's Guppy, right? Okay, now we are balling out of control on a disgusting level here, like a literal monster that lives in the trash is pretty much our level of ballin' right now. We're the Oscar the Grouch of Isaac, but in a great way. So, at this point, with this many keys, I think maybe, sure, we say fuck it and we go fight, the Hush. And now we don't actually need Empty Vessel to work. Oh my god. At least give me some keys. No keys in this whole situation here? What's better, Strength or Empress? I don't know that it really matters. But I'm assuming Strength. Because it's the damage multiplier, right? It's an experiment worth thinking about, at least, but... If we could pop both of them, that'd be great, but I definitely do want to keep this Joker card. The guys. Well, it basically paid for us to come in here. And because we've used the Sun card, now we actually can see where we're going, so... I guess it wasn't completely worthless. Yeah, I mean, even with only 6 HP, there's no way I can get away with saying, like, I'm worried about how this Hush fight is gonna go down, so we should definitely go for it. We'll have 7 HP, hopefully, assuming we take no more damage on this floor. We'll have the Strength card. Death, Stars, doesn't really matter. We'll also have whatever we get from our Deal with the Devil. I guess on our Deal with the Devil, I may spend HP, but that could be a good thing. Usually, if you're buying stuff, it's worth buying, you know? You got a choice in the matter. This has been... Yeah, we'll open that, but... This has been consistently, like, a really strong, really fun, and kind of novel run. That was awful. I just stood still because I was like, if I don't stay still, I'm going to move into the shot, but... We should have tried something else. Sure, you know what? Let's get into Empty Vessel. Take Little Brimstone with us. Now we only have 4 HP, but we do have Empty Vessel working. Not that that is relevant at all, necessarily. Joker card. Wait, what's more interesting? The Strength card or the Emperor, so we can just skip the Cathedral after we do our good stuff there. Let's take Strength. I want to make the Hush fight go as fast as possible. That's the one part of the game where I'm not ashamed at all to be like, we should skip through this as quickly as we can, because the Hush fight is kind of bullshit sometimes. So, spot the mistake. I definitely should have taken Bob's Rotten Head the first time it showed up. Thought maybe we could get a secret room there. There's the World card. It shows us that we have some golden chests available here. Who would have thought? Nod Leaf is worth taking, if for no other reason than if shit goes horribly wrong, we can at least stand still and Ball of Bandages will do the whole run for us. We'll take a Fly item, so that we can get closer to Beelzebub. And we'll take Chaos, because it's ridiculous, and we'll buy the Spirit Heart, and we'll buy the Pill. The Pill is bad gas. We're not gonna buy the Bible? You know what, fuck it, why not buy the Bible? Now the Bible will not show up later. Sadly, we're not gonna get too many opportunities for Chaos. Also, sadly, it probably pretty much ruins the whole reason we took Pandora's Box this far. And by that I mean that it might not guarantee us a deal with the Angel anymore. It might, but it might not. Alright, really easy opening to this fight. Getting lots of cards that may or may not be completely worthless. Trinity Shield is going to be awesome for us, by the way, at blocking these shots. Not as awesome as I thought it would be. That's okay. It's a little bit of a conundrum, isn't it? Because I want to get close enough to hit him with all three of my shots at the same time. But I don't want to be so close that we'd risk touching him. And unfortunately, those are pretty much mutually exclusive. I also want him to move so we can pick up as many of these as possible. I want better cards. Not the moon, though. That would be bad. Even if we tank a fuckload of damage, I think we're still going to kill him pretty easily here. Alright, this is where the flies come in. More batteries, more money. Don't really need this right now. Hagalaz is worthless. Just looking for cards, man. Give me like an Empress card now. Ooh, it's getting slightly dicey. They're getting real dicey. I don't even know where the Hush is at this point. The Stars, not wicked excited about that. Chariot. Oh, bad timing. Oh, we got another Chariot, though. And I lost it. I lost it somewhere in the fray here. You might be saying thank God for these cards, but at the same time, who do you think, you know, made the cards happen? We do. We do. Chariot. Pop it. Pop that shit. Get in there. We're fast enough. More flies, please. Less bullets, more flies. Stop shooting, I can't see shit. Kill me! Oh no, he did it! Okay, this is where we play. Take a second. That was bad. Joker card. We can only take one of these without dying. I think you gotta take Sin Robes. We could then take... Oh, we should have taken the... We should have taken the mushroom first. But this still gives us a chance. So you're saying there's a chance. Now take a moment here. Empress. That's some good shit right there. Good shit, good shit. That's some good shit, good shit. And we got the moon. So that's our go-to right now. Now we do have some permanent Polaroid invincibility. But we have to play better. I can't stress that enough. I just started tanking damage and acting like a fucking idiot, but we can still get out of this just fine. Normally, 9 lives would be a kiss of death, but we can generate so many cards, you know? Like, I'm actually amazed that in our game so far we have not generated a single Hierophant card. Because that's the stuff you look for right there. Also, I don't think I've used Little Brimstone a single time. For whatever reason, like, I'm incapable of dodging right now as well. What if we use AWAS? No, I was wishful thinking. So many teleport cards. Yo, runes are good, man. Hagalaz is not one of those runes, though. I know, by the way, that we can get in there. Anytime we get invincibility, we should really get in there and crack these to try to find as many cards as we can. Because one Hierophant changes the game. High Priestess does jack shit. Against this boss, at least. Just keep moving around. Maybe you've missed the teleport card somewhere in the whirlwind. We do have 99 bombs, but I think our tiers are more impressive, honestly. The Sun card. We have no age, no red hearts, so don't need to really go hard on that. There we go. The Devil is a big one. Use this opportunity to get even more cards. Blow up your Temperance card. We should be in the corner right now. What? We still got hit in the corner? This is a new era of despair. Oh my god. Well, at least it gives us a great chance in the future to pick up a bunch of shit we may or may not need in case we have to do this whole floor again. I mean, get in the corner. That's the normal strat here. Oh, wait. We're invincible. We're invincible. Get in that ass, Larry. Oh, my God. We did it. Never a doubt in my mind. Never a doubt in my mind. Okay, so we don't want the tower card. We can swap that out for anything. Apart from that, I'm not going to worry about it too much. Maybe a joker would be nice, but mostly I'm just worried about getting to the next floor. I'm going to go out on a limb. Say it might have been a small mistake to fight Hush. I guess World is actually pretty good. Okay, let's do that. Whoo! I ain't ever scared. Look at that. We got an Eternal Heart and a Thame. World card tells us where we go in here. 6 lives. I still love our chances, by the way. I mean, the chest is a little bit of a crapshoot, but can't be too mad. I'm mostly just happy to be alive right now. That run was looking like it was going to go completely south, but that's why you're watching if you're still watching. I have to assume that it's because you want to... You want to see that zaniness. If you want to watch me just steamroll an easy run when it looks like it's going to be easy, you just let me know. I want to go balls to the wall here, the bang dicky. I think I'm just going to Emperor. Like, double Emperor would be dope, but I'm going to take Emperor Worlds. And then we're going to pop the Emperor. We're going to fight Isaac. Who should go down pretty easily. I mean, we're no slouch, man. That was a horrible move on my part. We didn't get punished for it. That is... Oh, I actually thought that we would not have that situation. I thought our Eternal Heart would keep us alive. Alright, well, we should still be able to win without taking a hit here. But this is suboptimal, I'll agree. We got World and Stars. World Stars! This does nothing for us. Well, Stars can teleport us, I guess, which, depending on how the World card looks, might be the right decision, but... Who knows? It's a weird one. I'm not gonna go ahead and say that this is the easiest run of all time. I screwed myself by fighting the Hush, though, so at least I screwed myself. Four question marks. Perfect run. Perfect end to this run. Bogo Bombs. Lunch. Skeleton Keys. Steven. Steven is by far the best thing we got there. You know what? Stars is totally worthwhile here, except for the fact that it moved us, literally one room to the right. That being said, Contract from Below and a luck upgrade, or several luck upgrades. Sticky Bombs and Sack Dagger, pretty dope. Mostly Sack Dagger. We do have 99 bombs, though, so if we can actually get Egg Sack Bombs to work, more power to us. Fly Generation, ridiculous. Come on, I'm hoping like two chests every four rooms. Actually, that's like one chest every two rooms. Yo, yeah, I mean, I'm happy you can do fraction math, straw man that I invented in my head right now, but at the same time, it's not really, because functionally we're getting two chests every four rooms. We're either getting two or zero. Curse of the Tower is probably horrible. Halo of Flies is pretty good, although we were stacked up orbital-wise anyway. And this has also put us one step closer to Beelzebub, but I wouldn't get your hopes up too much. We're getting pretty late into the game to be hoping for another fly item. Which means, of course, now that I've mentioned it, it's definitely going to happen. Probably on, like, the boss will drop it or something. Ooh, we got to go back for that. I mean, the damage is disgustingly good. Devil Judgment. Cricket's Head, amazing. I popped the Devil card when my brain was telling me to pop the Judgment card. We might as well play Judgment. The run is basically over, but if he gives me an HP upgrade, it's probably literally over. The Two of Hearts is a nice pickup, too. Sad Bombs. Yeah, that's real good. Roid Rage. That also just gave us Spun. And then Book of Shadows. Okay, somebody up there really wants me to win. Well, we have to use Sad Bombs, or we have to give up our Wacky card. That worked out completely fine. That was a fun one. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, click the like button. Helps out a great deal. Of course, subscribe if you want to see more in the future. For now, thanks for watching, and I will see you next time.